What's up, guys? Doing some more Dark Souls. Whoa. I really should take some time to get some better equipment and get everything all set up here, but I guess I'm good with what I have. So anyway, we got the key to the depths in the last episode. There's Domhnall. He'll be coming to, oh look, it's even like dripping with... We'll be seeing Domhnall back in a Firelink Shrine. Here's a nice little touch. Again, just not super lore related, but just, you know, something to appreciate while my arms go through the ladder here. So yeah, it looks like the, you know, they broke off the metal ladder, and so it's the people from Blighttown below built the wooden ladder up to the ladder from before. And yeah, again, it's nothing crazy, it's just it just shows that there's some attention to detail or whatever here. Can I? No. Oops. This is not gonna go well. Just already, I can tell. Two guys coming. Gonna have to rubber band one of these guys. There's no way. Okay. Oh, is he just gonna walk off the edge? No, but the other guy did. Oh. These guys also disappear. Did one of those guys fall off the edge? That was so convenient for me. I'm not sure if I wanna go through the process of getting everything in Blighttown. There! Now these guys are bleeding. What did he drop? Just crap. Oh my god, I can't believe I didn't get hit by this toxic. Yeah, I think the best way to go about this is to come at it from below here. I don't know, maybe not. Oh, nope. Okay. Oh my god. Yeah, I mean, you let that go and you're pretty much... Gonna climb because I'd rather kill this guy than have that guy. I don't care if that guy follows me. Okay. Nice. And I will just go down here. Yeah, so I'm ouch. I'm not sure about the game design from the point of view of, you know, these toxic guys. Oh cool, I got one of their spears. I think they weren't necessarily meant to not despawn just because I don't know, it seems weird. Like, it seems like it's just so unmanageable that their only solution to their problem was to get them to be despawned. This part, you know, getting into the Blight Town here, it's just some of my least favorite. Because it's just like so many enemies. Like, it's not. I don't know, it's not all that interesting to me. Blight Town is, but not so much this part. So, yeah. There's a, you know, a weapon that I like here. I mean, it's very similar to the Uchi, but it's kind of hard to get sometimes, so of course I'm probably gonna die. Nice. Yaito. And now that bonfire appears for some reason. Alright, let's read the, I don't see what it says. Do we read the Uchi? Yeah. Katana forged in an eastern land. The katana is drawn from the scabbard at lightning speed using an yaijutsu technique. Yaijutsu allows the wielder to charge forward swiftly, cut down distant foes. Sure. Okay. Where's the easiest way to go from here? And this way is much better by doing this. So I'm always interested in this Eastern land that they talk about in all Dark Souls games. A lot of times, you know, it's like different lands have Eastern lands and. You know, backstab these guys. But it's interesting because you know you learn about different lands or whatever, and they're all relative to each other, and yet in all of these lands, they all have Eastern lands, and they all have Japanese things in them. Like the ninja stuff or the Iaido or whatever. Okay. Just, oh, these guys. Oh. Yeah, I meant to do that. Okay. I know what that item is over there. As I say, I'm not sure I want to go get everything in this because there's just so many like random pieces of loot. I don't even remember what everything is. There's the ninja set, there's the Ito, and then there's some obvious stuff that's, you know. Easy to get, it's not worth whatever, but it's like there's a bunch of like souls of the lost undead and stuff, and it's like, do you want to like, I don't know if there's a lot of lore around a lot of that stuff, so we'll see what we can do. Well, without further ado, let's at least grab this bonfire. And we might as well kindle it, because we have an extra humanity, and we're already human. And let's level up. Okay. Not level up, I said. I didn't mean to level up. I don't want to level up. Never want to level up. Have to fight these guys again. This is kind of a funny guy just sitting in this pot. All weird looking. can just tier like all 50 of the aggro. Oops. Let us just. Oh, good. I wanted that. I swear you can backstab these guys. Yeah. Alright, so I think if you just drop down on this, it breaks, but I think you can actually walk on it. As long as you don't break down, jump down. Which is weird, I just learned that. Who's gonna come and attack me? I know there's a toxic guy around here. Don't know if he can get me. I mean, he's somewhere. I don't know if he's right here. Oh yeah, I remember this part. There's the ninja set. Oh, that's okay, I see. Alright. Oh, I forgot. Again, this is one of those things where it's like, is it worth getting all this stuff? Drop down here. Soul Pride Knight. I mean, every soul counts. Oh, that guy fell off. Okay, not messing with this right now. Come over here, I don't want a toxic. Okay, I'm toxic. I am just going to make this easy. Okay, now I've gotten all that stuff up there. That toxic guy up there is definitely worth taking out. And he is best taken care of. That's a cool thing. Problem is, it's nice to go quickly through this area, but there's always these guys, you know, guys always come up. Well, that was a double hit. I don't think I can kill those guys with Oops. Thought that was an arrow. Yeah, so we can go over here and try to take this guy out, and he will screw us up very quickly. So we're gonna go a different way. By way of this toxic guy. Ugh, I hate the toxic guys. What the fuck? How did that guy come out of nowhere? toxic guy down. And now to this part. Oops. Forgot that it took all my stamina to fake parry him there. Probably wasn't the best idea. Please don't fall off. Okay. Trying to figure out where the whip is. I think you gotta continue to fall down for the whip, but I'm obviously gonna take this guy out. This is a weird section. I mean, you can't, like, tell that you're doing damage. Oh my god. I don't want to go up anyway. Who's following me? Toxic. I'm gonna go get that whip, I think. It's probably one of the more interesting items in this area. I mean, I say interesting, I just mean, like, it's not an item that you would, you know, get right away. You either have to search for it or get it by accident. I think this is the only way to get it, so. Sure, though. It's a bit treacherous. Oh, he bled out there, too. Whoa. Yeah, maybe this isn't the whip. Maybe the whip's down lower or something. There it is. So yeah, this is a way back here. Oh yeah, I was here before I grabbed that item. I just didn't come down here. Gotcha. Okay. Still sometimes a maze to me. What is that? It's weird, I should have grabbed the binoculars. If I'm doing a lore through, you gotta have the binoculars, you gotta see stuff. Yeah, so you can come through here and, like, do stuff, or you can come, where is it? I think it's just here, yeah. Oh my god. Okay. I think it's the shortcut to the bonfire, right? Do I just go down from here? Or do I still got it? It's quite a ways away. There's the chest with the dragon scale on it. Let's read what the whip says. Leather whip. Not intended for battle. Virtually ineffective against armor those and tough scales, but quite formidable against enemies with exposed skin. Okay. Well, don't worry, I'll never use it. Yeah, this is just a way to get down closer. Now we have the crag spiders. Yeah, we're making quick work of this whole area. This will be great. I love the Ring of the Evil Eye. Getting little bits of... a little bits of health back. Okay, apparently that's a drop down, not never to return again. Drop. Oh, there's more toxic guy. Oh, toxic guy. Oh my god. wander with the falchion. Again, if you started out as that, you already have that. I don't think any of that stuff has all that interesting. What is he doing back in there? Is he always there? But I guess we can read all that stuff. Oh gosh. It's like I know I'm already there. Why would I try to risk losing everything when I'm almost at the bonfire? Sometimes I make no sense. Oh! At least there's no toxic guys anymore. Somehow that made him bleed. We're just trying to go down here. Oh, I didn't get the... because I was trying to do whatever and there was a pyromancer. Or a pyromancer, a toxic guy. Weapon at risk. This is not good. I mean, I'm gonna go with this. Until I can get some better stuff. Some pyromancy, I think. I think that's our first pyromancy. Should just put this on my bar. It's just my hubris. I'm like, well, I will never get. Oh! Apparently, I hit again. Rip in peace, souls. That's Blighttown for you. Oh. It's just little things. Oh, right. Yes. I forgot. I do not have... Okay. I think it might be time for a speed run. Should have sped run to my souls, but oh, I'm gonna get hit again. I can tell. Oh, he died. Yeah, that's what that looks like when it gives me a random purple moss clump. There we go. There we go. That's why you don't speed run. least the toxic guy, I think, is gone. Because... Look at that. See, I'm an expert. Oops, wrong way. Just get away. We don't need to make this any more complicated than it needs to be. Why am I going up? That's not what I want. There we go. Out of my way, you crack spider pieces of gold. There's a lot of items down here, but obviously I'm just trying to get safe. The bonfire that I was so close to, and it was worth losing the 10,000 souls or so. Let us fight Maneater Mildred. Here's another. I think it's the exact same model, actually. And maybe that's just why. But someone obviously broke into here. Dragon scales. Dragon scale for reinforcing dragon weapons, peeled from an ancient dragon. A dragon is inseparable from its scales, and the transcendent apostles who seek the perpetuity of the ancient dragons have crossed the very end of the earth to seek this invaluable treasure. So there are people that kind of look up to the dragons as... I mean, I suppose in one sense there's, you know, everyone is just trying to get over the undead curse, you know what I mean? Like, you know, different people do it in different ways. Some, you know, try to look to gods, some try to look to, like, humanity as a, you know, as a item. Some look to, you know, dragons. And, or, you know, sorceries, I guess. You know, we have Big At Logan looking at sorcery as a way to transcend through wisdom. Yeah, how am I gonna do this? I can't repair, can I? I didn't buy anything. Let me do Maneater Mildred with this Eido, and then I'll just... We're gonna take a short. There we go. Then we're gonna take a short break and, you know, go back up and repair stuff. I forgot to repair it. I thought that I was gonna be good. Yeah, that's fine. That was a partial parry. Lucky. There you go. Good that Mildred just dodges no matter what. Hello. She also has a sack on her head. I wonder if she's from the depths. Oh, Maneater! Right. She's just a butcher. She's just one. She just has a name. Well, let's look. Butcher, giant butcher knife wielded by the undead man-eating cook lurking in the depths. More a tool for subduing and preparing live catches than an actual weapon. Those who have faced this deadly blade have a deeper sense of how helpless prey must feel. It's brutal. I think it gives you back life, too. At least it does in other games. Okay. Well, before we go and try to do something silly, although what I'm gonna do here is gonna be pretty silly, we're gonna go back to this Firelight Shrine. There's a lot of stuff I want to talk about on the way, but we'll see. Can you see it from up here? No. Of course, I'm drawing all the mosquitoes close to me. Here. Really want to get all that stuff, but that's gonna be later. Oh my gosh. This could be it for me. No way to cure it. There is a sorcery that would have helped me out here. Goes on for so long. It's so deadly. I didn't get any new that would have been nice. I like can't even climb a ladder without fearing my death. Okay, so here's the key to the New Londo Ruins. We're not gonna read it. We're just gonna get out of here. Okay, hopefully I can get to a place to heal. Okay. Belly of the Drakes, really exciting place. Gonna explore it in time. Now I'm just trying to save my life and make the depths a little bit more bearable. If this is your first time, you're probably like, what the heck? Useless detour here. Alright. Does anyone have anything new to say?
Did you see her? That virtuous little maiden, complete with followers in tow? They're probably going straight to pillage graves. I've heard enough about Milady for a lifetime.
Milady, I know that is. this.
How did that old man make it back? Unexpected. But I suppose stranger things have happened.
He's just surprised by everything.
Hmm? What now? I'm not up.
Okay, well, let's get all of our buddies here. So we have Laurentius that we freed from the man-eater cooks.
Well, I see you made it out. Yeah, I made it out safely too. I have my Pyromancy of the Great Swamp, so I can usually manage with a bit of care. Oh yeah, by the way, I can share my spells with you. I think you have a knack for it. All you need are the materials. I'll be pleased to help you. Ah, and unless you find the magic's unsavory?
No, I like magic.
Yeah, wonderful. I'm sure that, you know, they'll be of some use, some assistance. Here, first take this.
Pyromancy flame.
A flame from the Great Swamp. Now you're a fully fledged pyromancer.
Really?
Well, let's get started right now.
It should be noted that the Great Swamp is not Blighttown, by the way. All right, I think what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna get all the get everything here from Firelink Shrine, and then we'll start the next episode in Blighttown again. Kill Quaylag. All right. Flaming fire orb explodes on impact, causing fire splash damage. In a spectacle which seemed to symbolize the strength of fire manipulating pyromancers. Now we get to learn about pyromancy. One of the most basic pyromancies. Pyromancy of Carmina, who harnessed the power of flame to actualize the inner self. Iron flesh boosts defense and resilience. Use of this pyromancy requires caution, as the caster becomes exceedingly heavy and I'm unable to move freely. Pyromancy flash sweat. Pyromancy of Carmina, who harnessed the self power of flame to actualize the inner self. Intense sweating reduces flame damage. Carmina, the most accomplished pupil of Salaman, the master pyromancer, pioneered the new directions for the art of pyromancy. The Great Swamp, I think, is, you know, an area far away from here, and I think that, you know, there's kind of a line of pyromancers, just the way there is with sorcery and, to a certain extent, miracles. But, Salaman seems to be kind of the grandfather of all pyromancy. I mean, not the creation of it, but he really mastered the art of it. And apparently Carmina is the most accomplished pupil and used it for different things. And I think it's kind of, obviously the lore is kind of interesting, but it more just leads to the idea that, you know, pyromancy is kind of broadly used. It can be used for damage, for fire, or it can be used to, like, buff yourself or poison or all these other things. So we should at some point start leveling up this pyromancy flame. I don't know that we're going to use it, but I certainly want to get it up to plus 10. In fact, I'm probably just going to go up to plus 5 here. So that we can just, you know, whatever. And let's talk. See what it is. Anything else to say?
Pyromancy is the art of casting fire. Produce flame, then channel it. Just as our ancestors did. A pyromancer must be in tune with nature herself. My home, the Great Swamp, is an abundant store of nature. You will understand one day. It only takes time.
Yeah, I think even more than sorceries, the pyromancy kind of requires the teacher-student relationship. I mean, it's certainly seen in sorceries as well, but there's almost a, you know, religious sense of... It's funny, I mean, all magic has its own sense of religiosity or lack thereof. You have the miracles, which... involve faith in the gods and the tales of the gods, and then we have sorcery, which kind of is like anti-faith. It's about intelligence and wisdom, but has a teacher-student relationship. And then this is more like the fire. It's all about nature and the, you know, and obviously The origins of pyromancy are quite interesting, and we'll dive into that later, but...
Pyromancy has a, well, rather primitive aspect to it. It meshes poorly with advanced culture, and pyromancers are considered rather unsavory, which is fine, as I never got along with anybody anyway. So, for me, turning undead didn't change a thing.
Yeah, so people don't like pyromancers. They don't like undead. Pyromancy is a very solitary art form, I guess.
A pyromancer's flame is a part of his own body. The flame develops right along with his skill. When I gave you that flame, I gave you a part of myself. Please take good care of him. A pyromancer's flame, please take...
Yeah. Or talk about how...
Goodbye, then. Come back if you find anything new.
More evidence that it's very sacred. Well, apparently that's the old man that came back, but let's see what, actually, let's talk to Lautrec, just in case. I know he has a few things to say about Patches and Petrus.
Oh, hello. I'm considering a change of location. I have a rather pressing matter to attend to up above. That keeper has served me well, but enough with her. Oh, I'm cons- I have a- that-
This keeper? Alright, enough with her. Anything change here?
Did you see them? The three young clerics headed for the catacombs to seek kindling. Kindling is the art of feeding bonfires. The poor young girl sent down into a tomb. What a terrible mission she is burdened with.
Seems like everyone knows about what her mission is. I had to pay for it.
Oh, hello. Myself. I wish to do what I can to locate Master Logan. I am aware of my shortcomings, but I cannot very well just sit around here and rot. Oh, do not worry. I have considered our relationship. I will only leave after I have taught you all the sorceries that I know. I shall count myself lucky if I manage to locate Logan, or even return here in one piece. Two things are... Then you... Oh!
Yeah, well, goodbye, then. I don't intend to buy all your sorceries, so maybe I'll find Logan first before you leave. And here we are. What's going on, Petrus? Who are these people?
Oh, hello. My guests have finally arrived. I will be departing with them shortly. So, I'm afraid I will be saying goodbye soon. It was a pleasure.
Oh, okay.
Oh, hello. Miracles, I presume?
No.
Rhea is the youngest daughter of the good House of Thurland. Those young knights are her old schoolmates. But I'm not sure what to make of them. I'm afraid they may be a bad influence.
So...
Come again. The effectiveness...
Rhea... is of nobility in Thurland. She's the youngest daughter of the good house of Thurland. So she's quite special, and it's interesting to me, I mean, although not incredibly such, that, you know, she, even though she's a princess... She still goes on the undead mission. I wonder if it's forced upon her or whether she's, you know, looking for it. So we have Nico and Vince. Let's talk to Vince first, as he has more things to say.
Hmm? What have we here? You look awfully raggedy. Times are grim.
The least you can do is look sharp. Don't you dare meet my lady like that. You might scare her off for good.
I think I'm good, too.
Oh, you again. What business have you? I don't suppose we can help, though. We accompany my lady on her righteous mission. It is quite a chore, but I'm stuck with her, and Nico, too. I can't very well abandon them now.
I don't want you to, I just want to talk.
Oh, it's you. We're to leave momentarily. The catacombs aren't exactly my idea of a good time, but what can one do? I do hope we meet again. Rerya Nox.
Oh, we're best friends. Rerya Nox is like supposed to be faux Latin or whatever. It's part of their religion, I think, so. Nico, what do you have to say about this undead mission? Right. Well, I know you think I look like crap. I think I look rather stunning, so I'm going to speak with Rhea anyway.
You are undead as well. Then we've no time to fraternize. I have my mission, and you no doubt have yours. We must not let this curse overcome us. Did I not explain the urgency of our tasks? Or are you so uncouth as to lack such judgment? By the looks of you, I should think not.
It's a little bit judgy.
Did I not explain...
Okay. Well, I believe that's all the bookkeeping we have to do here in Firelink. I'm gonna go back up and talk to. I don't think he leaves unless we kill Quelaag or we get the Firekeeper soul from Blighttown. So I think he's good to remain there for a while, which is good. So I'm gonna try to get my stuff repaired. And I might even... It would be good to have the Eido as plus 5 as well. At least at some point. Oh, I can send this to plus 6 though. I can do that instead of repairing it. I mean, if I pop a few souls, I can get a repair box. I mean, it's probably just worth my time. I mean, an armor smith box would all, or a weapon smith box would be good too, but, you know, between the two. Oh, we have plenty of souls here. Let's just use this. That'll probably be good enough for everything we need to do.
Ah, why, that's a fine ember you have there. I could smith some mighty weapons with one of those. Why not lend it to me?
Sure, lend it. I'll give it to you.
Magnificent! You won't be disappointed. I can hardly wait to get started.
Do you have anything new to say?
I know little of the those.
Okay, let's just modify this. It repairs it and it brings it to plus 6. And how much would this? So I have 1, I need 8. 8 times 800. 6,400 souls plus, you know, couple thousand.
Don't get you.
Let's try it. I mean, it might just help. I mean, we do have, or wait, we want the repair box. That's what we want.
Well, you need anything for?
All right. Purchase repair box. Yeah, that will be,
Don't get you. Night.
I'd rather that than, I don't need the Eido. So yeah, I guess this is a good time to break here, and the next time I come back, I'm just going to be down in Blighttown where we left off. This was just a temporary side mission. See you next time.